Today, you are going to learn to create your own blockchain in Java, the blockchain that is at the heart of the success of the Bitcoin and the other cryptocurrencies. In blockchain, you have block. So we are going to design the block in a block class. Our block class will have an index, a timestamp, to store its creation date, then a hash calculated with the SHA-256 algorithm from the content of the block. The hash ensures the integrity of the block's data. The previous hash field to link the current block to its previous block via its hash. Some data in string format here, and a nonce field is used during the mining of the block. In the constructor, we set nonce to 0 and we calculate a first version of the hash by calling the calculateBlockStatic method. Then we generate getters for the data, the hash, the index, previous hash, and the timestamp. We create the calculate hash method, which will take a string in parameter and will calculate its hash with the SHA-256 algorithm. Fortunately, the Java SDK offers us an implementation of this algorithm in standard. Try to get the instance of the SHA-256 algorithm by calling the getInstanceStatic method of the MessageDigest class, and we return null if the algorithm is not found. In the str method, we return the string representation of the block. We concatenate all the fields of the block, except its hash property. To make easier the display of the block's content, we override its toString method. Finally, we have to define the mindBlock method. In this method, we will solve the proof of work for the current block given a specific difficulty passed in parameter. The nonce property will store the number of tries before we solve the proof of work during the mining process for the current block. The difficulty will determine the number of zero we will have at the start of the hash we want for the current block. While the calculated hash is different of the expected hash, we will continue the mining process. When the proof of work is solved, the block is mined and the hash property is valued. We define the zeros method in the utils class. This method is used to return a string with a number of zeros entered in parameter. In the second part of this tutorial, we will create the blockchain class. So stay with us.